Hey guys, so today we're going to be talking mainly about ggplot, and we're going to be starting off with multivariate graphs and how to make them. So first we want to start off with what we always would do. We want to set our working directory. We want to clear out the environment that we have, start with a clean and fresh slate, and then load all of our packages that we're going to be using. Next, we want to load in our data. We're going to be calling on the WDI clean dataset, and we're going to be naming it DAC. So we do that. And now we're going to try to be plotting variables against each other on both a x and y axis. So we're going to start off basic with a scatter plot. There's a bunch of different plots that we can make. We could make histograms, we can make bar plots, et cetera, using different geom underscore blank. So as you can see here, there's a lot of choices that we have. But since we want to make a scatter plot, we're going to be using geom point. And as we can see here, we're going to be using the DAT dataset, which is why that's there. And then our x-axis is going to be year, and our y-axis is going to be renewable energy use. So this is a really basic code for any graph that you're going to be making. So as you can see by taking a look at our graph, we don't really get a clear read on what's going on here. So we can use the table DAT.assign year to see how many observations there are per year. You can see that there's about 217, which is a lot, and because it's all overplotted, it's kind of hard to draw conclusions and see what's going on. There's a bunch of ways that we can code this exact same data differently to kind of get a better read on it. So one way you can do that is just adjusting the opacity of points. So if we do that, we can kind of see where things overlap, where there's a high concentration of data and points versus a not so high concentration. So we're going to be using the exact same code that we had before, but we're going to be using this to change the opacity. And when we do that, we can kind of get a little bit better of a understanding of where things are overlapping. But, you know, if we want to make it even clearer, we can use the jitter function to also reduce overplotting. So this will move the values a little bit to the right, to the left, up and down to offset overlapping. So we're gonna, again, be taking the exact same code, but we're gonna add position equals position jitter to do that. So as you can see, it may look a bit more crazy, but now there's a lot less overlapping, right? So we can get a little bit better of an understanding there. Another way to do that, we can change the default jitter value with the width and height parameters inside the position jitter argument. So we can change the width here, and by decreasing the width, we can increase the visual separation between years. So you get a little bit different there. We can also add trend lines if we want to make an even clearer statement about the data and draw conclusions from that. So by using stat smooth and adding on this to the end of our code, we can overlay a line with a line of best fit over our graph. So it shows us that globally, the usage of renewables has decreased a little bit over time. And you can see that in the decrease in the line. So another way to distinguish is that we can use color. So suppose that we want to know whether the evolution in the use of renewable energies differs between rich countries and poorer countries. One way you could do this is to create a binary variable to code the wealth of countries and pass this variable to the color aesthetic. So, so we can use median per capita GDP value as a cutoff point to split the sample into roughly two equal size groups. So we can do this, we can make note of this by coding a rich country as 1 and a poor country as 0. So if we want to look at this, we can split it here, so we're basically using if-else function to code that there. And now, as we can see by using the table here, we can see it's about equal our two groups, our rich country and our poor country. So now we're going to add this to our graph code. So we're going to add that in, and we're going to be coloring by factor by rich. As we can see in our data set, when we ran the previous line of code, we added a variable here for rich, and it tells us whether the country is poor or rich. So now that we have that, we can add that to our graph. And if we run that, we get a little bit better of a read here, because now we can see where the poor countries are and where the rich countries are in terms of renewable energy use. So this plot actually suggests that rich countries have lower levels of renewable energy usage, and that on average, the percentage of energy that comes from renewables has not changed that much over time, regardless if we're talking about rich or poor countries. Another way that we can distinguish things on top of all this is we can use shapes. So sometimes color isn't what we want to use. Sometimes we want to, instead of having a bunch of circular dots, as you can probably tell in the graph, maybe we want to use different shapes to differentiate. So we can do that by adding in shape here. So we're doing the exact same thing as color. We want to sort it by the factor of the variable rich. So we're adding that in. And now, so as you can see here, there are both circles and triangles. Triangles to denote rich countries and circles to denote poor countries. So that's another way to do it. And another way, I think the last way that we're gonna look at for now, is we can use faceting to distinguish groups. So we can also plot separate scatter plots for each group using faceting. So we're gonna be using facet wrap now we're gonna be using facet grid to plot the relationship across two variables. Suppose we want to know whether there is a difference in the relationship between per capita energy consumption and the percentage of renewables in poorer versus richer countries, and that we also wanted to know how the relationship changes over time. We will then only plot the relationship for years where exists data on per capita energy consumption. In our case, that will be 2000, 2010, and 2012. So how would we do that? So we'd be taking our ggplot function, and we need to first specify, we want to take out the NAs, so we're removing NAs with this, and then we want to specify the years. The years will only be these 3 years, so we're using C parentheses to select the years that we want, and then we're plotting X by energy use, by population, and Y is renewable energy use. And then the rest remains the same, but we want to add in facet grid to make, to use faceting to make our multiple graphs. So if we run that, we can see here, we have a bunch here. This column is for poorer countries, and this one is for richer countries. And it's by the years that we want to look at. And I think here, we actually selected different countries than the ones that we mentioned. So we can actually fix that right now. We just go in and change the years that we want. And then we rerun the code to overwrite that. And there we go. Now we got our data that we want.